Alrighty, folks, it's Farrow and Holly with Crowd Surfing. And Holly, why are we here?
We are here for the Days of 47 Rodeo.
I know. I've never been to the Days of 47 in Salt Lake, ever.
Well, yeah. Look how big it is. This is a big deal.
I know. They have lasers and a big TV and all kinds of stuff.
A huge celebration outside, which are we going to go out there and talk to some folks?
Yeah, let's go
out
there. They got barbecue. I smelled it when I came in.
There's barbecue. There's, like, horse riding. There is bull riding.
Yes.
Not actual bull, but, like, you know the one they have at the L.A. restaurant?
Yeah, Urban Cowboy.
I don't know what that means, but that's going to happen. I think there's, like, bands and fun, and then, of course, the rodeo.
Yes, and food.
And food.
That's the most important part, food.
Really? What are you going to have?
Whatever you're buying me.
That's not going to happen. All right, let's go.
Go.
Made our way over to the rodeo, but there's all kinds of fun stuff happening outside. When does the rodeo start, guys? Do we know what time? 7 o'clock? Okay, rodeo starts at 7. So we have some time to entertain ourselves. We're just going to start with Farrell right here riding the mechanical bull. This just seems right.
Why do you want me to do this? Why?
Because you think you're a cowboy. You live in Ogden, you're like, I'm a cowboy, I'm awesome, I listen to country music, you make fun of country music that's not country enough. I think it's time to, like, freaking mount up.
What does riding a bull have to do with country?
Proving your cowboyness. Either you're a girly cowboy or you're a rough and tough cowboy man. Here we go.
Alrighty, can I get your guys' names?
Yep, I'm Caitlin Paxton.
I'm Christina Mewelstein.
And I'm gonna ask the dumbest question in the world. What are you guys doing down here?
We're Days of 47 Royalty, here to celebrate.
We come to all the rodeos. It's really exciting, and we'll be waving and be introduced here.
All right, I am here with Mr. Tennessee.
Yes.
And last name?
Stewart.
Tennessee Stewart, is that your real name?
No, my real name is John Stewart, but, you know, I don't like being just another John, so.
That makes perfect sense, and Tennessee works.
When you said Tennessee and she asked your last name, I thought for sure you were going to say Ernie Ford.
No. Thank God he's dead and gone.
See that really interesting looking person? Can we just stick him right on here and you and I can talk about what you do and make fun of him?
Sure.
Absolutely. Farrell. Oh no, you'll hurt it. Go ahead. Want me to hold your phone? Here, I'll hold your stuff.
Boy, that's a first. What are we doing, Holly?
I'll sit him right here.
I gotta sign something, don't I?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, see, I may have done this before.
Well, that means he's been hurt and knew he needed to sign something. This is going to be good.
I was just going to ask. I realize you have to be pretty well versed in riding a horse and stuff like that. You know what I mean? You got to be more than just a pretty face to become a... Is it a princess? Is it a... What do they call it?
Royalty.
Royalty. Thank you. Yeah, I didn't want to come up with some jerk. Oh, look, there go the princesses. And they're like, that guy's an idiot. He called us princesses. Do you know who Tennessee Ernie Ford is?
No. Is that bad?
Way before your time.
Okay, then I won't feel so bad. He likes the, like, really, like, Porter Rockwell?
Porter Wagner, Holly. Porter Wagner. Yeah. She has no idea who Porter Wagner is. Not a clue.
Not a clue. What about Bill Monroe?
No.
Okay.
Tex Ritter?
No. But we're rodeoing here tonight.
Yes.
Okay, take it easy on me. I'm an old man.
Please don't. Okay. Can I get you to take some pictures of this? And then you and I, let's talk, and then I'm wondering if you can let him see me control it.
Well,
you can show me how you do it a little.
Well, a little bit, but it's kind of dangerous.
Oh, then I don't want to do anything. Okay, so now tell me your name.
Cal Perkins.
From Idaho.
You're from Idaho, and tell me about this. You obviously...
I build and sell these bulls. So
really?
So we're, I've been making them for 23 years. So we,
How much work and time and effort goes into doing what you guys do?
So we are not rodeo royalty, but we're over the whole Days of 47. So we do a lot of Utah history, a lot of community service, and then there's a pageant in which we're chosen.
Oh, really?
Yeah, definitely.
we're part of all the Days of 47 events. So basically all that you can think of, including the rodeos, and we go and speak to youth groups and also the Lions Club. Different clubs let us come and talk about the pioneers to them.
Tell me what's happening.
This is a Days of 47 rodeo. We have the premier rodeo in the state of Utah, number 5 in the nation as far as payout goes. We're over $300,000 on payouts. We've got the top cowboys in the nation from tonight through Saturday night. We got the one-armed bandit. We've got barbecue and beer. Yes, we got 3 of the premier barbecuers in the state of Utah. And then Saturday, we have a barbecue cook-off. There'll be 23 contestants.
Really?
Yes.
So are your riders starting to get tired?
Can we go faster?
Yes.
Let's get him off.
Okay, we'll try to buck him off now. He's riding pretty good, though.
Don't say that on camera.
Yeah!
There we go. Pretty good ride.
No, I have a bad back.
And I don't?
I think you should do it again.
No, I shouldn't.
The most important question I have is, I don't got any tickets. You got to give me free tickets or something, can't you?
We'll see what we can do.
We'll fill you up some tickets.
We'll see what we can do.
I'm just kidding. But you're like, oh my gosh, this idiot's serious. No, I'm just kidding. Thank you so much for talking with me.
Yeah, hey, good to talk to you. Thank you.
Bye.
And up front, we've got a petting zoo. We also have mutton busting for the kids. And then we've got a mechanical bull for people to ride.
Oh, I already put him on the bull.
Yeah, well, I shoot the bull a lot, too.
Now, you said you have been over this event before. How many years have you been doing this?
This event here, I think I've been four years here on the outside. I just work the outside. I don't have anything to do with the inside at all, you know.
Well, this is a party. You've got the fun job.
I have the fun job. It's all the partying's going on out here. And then when everybody gets full of food, we send them inside. They watch the rodeo, come back out, and we have a concert after the rodeo. So it'll be fun all night.
Okay,
awesome
so...
Awesome ride.
Awesome. I'll be honest with you. Cal said you did a good job.
Yeah, but it's his job to be nice to people.
It's true. Okay, so Cal, you build these?
Yeah, in Idaho we build them. We've been building since 1992, and they're world.
I'm in Milner.
Partner? We live by Milner, Idaho.
I grew up in Burley.
Oh, yeah. we actually have a ranch right there by Milner, 5 miles downstream.
There you go. Yeah,
that's where I grew up, Burley, Idaho.
Oh, that's cool.
Okay, tell me your name.
Ree Zafiropoulos.
Ree, where are you from?
Originally from California, but moved to Cedar City, Utah about 35 years ago.
So tell us what you're doing here today. You have, these horses are just beautiful. Holy cow.
Thank you. They're English Shire horses, and we have a foundation, and we do rodeos, parades, and educational programs to let people know about the Shire horse.
So free concert?
Free concert, free water. Of course, you have to buy the barbecue and the beer and the ticket to get in.
You know what? All the trucks with the barbecue, every cool place in Salt Lake is here with a truck and barbecue. It makes me hungry.
It is. You should go try some.
I will. And then you have the ribs and rodeo thing. Explain that.
That's where you get it. You buy a ticket to eat ribs, and you get a ticket for the rodeo for the same price, and it's VIP. So, you know, got a little extra treatment. But you don't have to buy a ticket to the rodeo to eat ribs and have the concert.
You can just come here and get the ribs and the free water and the beer.
Of course, you have to pay for the beer.
Oh, yeah. See, Farrell, I told you.
Will you buy me ribs? I would be so nice of you to buy me dinner.
So how did you get into doing this?
I was a professional cowboy in the 70s to 1982, and my sons were starting to ride, and they were in junior high and sixth grade, so I built a machine for them to practice.
What a cool dad are you!
And it took off. We actually went to the College of Southern Idaho, and Sean Davis, the world champion saddle bronc rider, picked it up for his team, and then we went from there.
So tell me a fun fact about these guys.
Well, there's about 45 registered shires in the world.
Okay. Wow.
And if they were not domesticated, they would be on the endangered species list. Our horses weigh close to 2,000 pounds and are about 18 two hands high, which means they're at least 6 feet at the withers, and their head is at least eight feet in the air when they're standing there.
They are so beautiful.
Wouldn't that be nice if Holly to buy me dinner?
Where is this, like, why are you putting Tennessee through this awkward situation?
So tell me why you're so special that she should buy you dinner.
I mean, Tennessee.
A good-looking lady like this, you should buy her dinner.
That's how life should just work.
I would buy her dinner, but my wife keeps me broke. You know what I mean? She has the pocketbook, so I ain't got any money.
That's what you say every time.
I know, and you buy me dinner every time. It works out perfect.
He just plays this sob story. So what if somebody just wants one in their backyard?
Well, they can contact us there, and we actually have sold to private parties and private people.
Yeah? How do they get in touch with you if we need one of these at your party?
Well, my website is www.a-pmechanicalbull.com, and then I'm at 208-731-5541. And we're out of Idaho, southern Idaho, and like I said, we've sent them worldwide. They're all over, so.
Oh, my goodness. I totally want our next party to have one of these. Yeah?
This guy found your phone.
I still got your phone.
Why would you lie, guys? Come on. Don't just, because Farrell tells you. Look at how easily, look how sad. Look, why would you manipulate this poor young boy? Look how sweet he is. He's terrified. So tell me about the nature of these horses. Are they sweet? Are they aggressive? What's their story?
Well, they're called gentle giants, and the Shire is particularly, I think the English are very particular about their breeding, and these horses are just incredibly sweet.
That's really fun. So besides all of the educational stuff, they're getting all dressed up and fancy. What are they going to do here at the rodeo?
Well, we're going to go in and we're going to take the governor this evening. And Chris, our driver and trainer, is going to go in and do some intricate procedures to show the crowd what he can do with these guys. They're incredibly athletic.
Oh, that's awesome.
That's why Holly has boots on.
I get nervous.
This is my assistant.
Oh yeah, does he want to talk to us?
Don't be messing around with these people.
Here, talk to her. She is talking.
Yeah, give me the goods on this guy. Where are you from?
Oh, I tell you what, this guy's bad. Don't mess around with this guy. He's pretty bad now.
He's a bad guy, like bad as in like cool bad or like genuinely bad.
Oh, genuinely bad.
Really? Well, then what are you doing rolling with him? Because he just said you're his like best friend and his like right hand.
I gotta watch him what he says.
He was taking pictures of you. I was being nice, like I always am. And I said, hey, because Farrell always takes pictures at events, and I'm horrible, and I forget.
I'm a sweetheart, and I think about others.
So what do? I have this sweet boy take pictures of you on the mechanical bull, so you have him for your Facebook of you, like, falling off. And then you manipulate. Don't even touch my face.
Why did you call him sweet boy? He's a handsome young man. Sweet boy makes him sound like a sissy. Don't let her talk like that to you, bro.
I mean handsome young man. You are obviously a very handsome young, almost adult, 18.
Almost, 17.
Exactly. See, I knew that. Fine. So they're trained and they do all kinds of fun stuff?
Yes.
How did you get into this?
Well, my husband saw them when we were in England, and he said, that was a horse. And I said, yes, but you're insane. And I was used to quarter horses, and then at one time we had 21. And
Now
I'm down to 10, 3 retired, and then we have the hitch horses.
So this is more than just a passion. I love that you do education and everything too. That's really cool.
Yeah, I think that's important.
Is it kind of like one of those keep your friends closer, enemies, whatever that quote is? Friends close, enemies closer.
Enemies even closer.
Yeah, there you go.
Yes.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
In all seriousness, tell me what you do here at this event besides, you know, keep the sidewalk clear of Bill.
Well, we do a little bit of everything, but mainly watch him. Just
that's your job?
See that he's working.
Everybody needs to have a job, and I could sense that he would need a person like you.
I'd say the two of us are troubleshooters.
That's what we are.
Yeah.
I would say when I saw both of you, I saw trouble.
Yeah.
Right out of the gate. Are you from Spring City as well?
Spring City? I'm from Iowa.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. Right. Oh, see there, he got out.
I come out of here.
Now he's talking.
Well, you're skirting the issue.
Thanks for being nice and taking pictures for Holly. Anytime. I appreciate it.
It was actually for you. You can thank both of us right now if you'd like to. Here's the microphone. Be polite.
I would like to express gratitude
to Holly,
to this handsome gentleman right here for taking pictures. What's your name, my friend?
Munson McKay.
Munson. Thank you, Munson, for taking pictures. I appreciate it.
Munson?
With Holly's phone, of course, but that's...
His name is Munson.
Yeah, Munson.
That's rude.
Hey,
try again. That
Holly.
Work. Take two of being actually nice. Here we go. And go.
Hey, man. Thanks for talking to me. I appreciate it.
No problem.
Thank you.
What? Well, thank you so much for talking to us. I would like to just, you know, take one if I could, right? That was the deal they made with me.
What would you like to do?
I get to take one of your horses home with me.
No, I'm not going to let you do that.
Oh, well, I think they said that was, you know, what if I did the interview, I could take the horse home, right, Farrell? That's what we understood, right?
Holly, do you realize how much work a horse is?
Seriously, how much food do you have to feed that guy? It's got to be more than we have to feed this one.
I know. And the other thing is you have to do it morning, noon, and night, and whether it's raining or snowing or muddy or hot or cold. So.
Do you have an idea, pounds, like how many pounds do they eat a day?
Yeah, about 50 pounds of hay and about 25 pounds of grain.
That's a lot of food.
And a lot of water.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Let's have the dance. It's a Clinton Black, no less.
Well, how did that happen?
Yeah, let's get up there, Holly. Come on, let's go. This is the best thing ever. That's what you get for being the prettiest girl at the dance. Here we go. Alrighty, can I get your name?
Janet.
And who is this little person?
This is Reagan.
What's your name?
Reagan.
You know what? Usually Holly's here, and she's way better at talking to adorable children than I am. So is this your daughter, your granddaughter, your sister? Your granddaughter. And has she ever been to a rodeo before?
Of course.
Of course, all the time, huh?
Of course.
We took my kids to ride horses one time. And we're trying to explain to them how much work it is. You know, you just don't get a horse and just ride it around and leave it, you know. And so a friend of ours that has horses explained to my kids, you have to go feed them every day, even on Christmas. And my kids are like, oh.
I know. That's my dad told me that, too, when I was a little girl growing up on a ranch. But it's great training for any young person. Teach them responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
And it never ends.
That's why I can never have a horse, Holly, because let's face it, I'm lazy.
You know, you said it. All right, Miss Ray, well, thank you for talking to us. Good luck tonight. Are you going to be here all week for the whole?
Yes, we are.
And will you be doing something in every rodeo?
Yes.
Very cool. Well, good luck with everything. Can I go over here and say hi to one, or will he be distracted?
No.
All right, tell me this one's name.
This is, I can't see him. This is Stanley.
Stanley, hi.
Oh, wait, I gotta get a picture of this. Have you ever noticed how anybody's from somewhere backwoods Utah toward Manti, Holly's like their best friend? Oh, hey, I'm from Manti! And, you know, nobody really cares, but we still do it. You know what I mean?
That was a ballerina bow. Yeah. That was Dorky.
That was our dance.
That was our dance.
Hey, Holly, how come you never dance with me?
Awesome. Are you saving a dance for me, Glenn?
Glenn, watch
this. You
you're in
dance?
Trouble. You're in trouble.
What?
I
you're
do.
You're in trouble. Look.
Hey.
No. I don't dance. No.
You know this guy's available for a dance.
Huh?
Hey.
This is like her third rodeo.
Oh, really?
Her fourth.
So she knows what's going on then.
She does.
And she got to ride the ponies, because what's more fun than that?
There you go. And last year, we got to go to the National Rodeo Finals. So.
Oh, in Vegas.
In Vegas. So
that would be great, wouldn't it?
We're excited about seeing this one.
Yeah, I bet. All righty, well, thank you for your time. I appreciate it.
Okay.
Oh, here we go. Okay, so here, let me move my hair so I can move my head. Okay, see, now if I have this, then we can talk and you can tell me what I'm doing.
Well, this is what you call a country western dance.
Okay. All right. Look, if I can host a show and dance, that's like, you know how Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers, we're doing really good here.
Yeah.
But our band stopped. Yeah. I think we scared them off. Is it our dancing?
This man's coming up. I gotta talk on the phone then.
All right, you're a busy man. Just like that. Dance and leave. Story of my life.
You're holding up the line, sir.
Usually I get yelled at. It's nice to hear someone else get yelled at.
There's really no line, but I just love to.
No, it's nice. Usually the people are yelling that at me. Why is it every person that's from Backwoods, Utah, you're like, oh, I'm from Anti. Oh, do you know my mom's uncle's nephew? Oh, yeah, he works in the farm out there. Oh, yeah, well, my sister's brother's nephew, he's a pig farmer. Yeah, and he shears the sheep. Why does that happen every time you know somebody from
Backwoods, Utah? Are we talking about, like,
Manti,
Lieutenant Governor and, like, you know, my mom who was head of graduation at Snow College?
Hey, whatever you want to call it, Holly, I'm just asking.
Pharaoh,
just a question I had.
I want to bash on Ogden, because I love Ogden.
That's right, Ogden rules.
And you're being mean right now. Oh, Manti.
I'm not being mean. I'm just asking why, as soon as someone mentions they're from that part of the country, you're all of a sudden, this is your life.
So I grew up in Manti.
Oh, you did?
Yes, I did. I know Spring City.
Oh, okay, then, so there we go.
All routes lead home to Manti.
That's, well, yeah.
Or at least Sampy County.
Yeah, Sam.
I got a little bit confused and excited, but it's amazing. Like, you always know someone.
So awful.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Why are you talking? Shh. Seriously, I apologize for the unprofessionalism of this interview, sir. But okay, so this is happening throughout the weekend. If you want to get tickets to the rodeo and the ribs, that's available. Otherwise, just show up and have some fun.
Just show up and have fun.
All right.
Free water.
We're going to do that.
Less party.
Let's do it.
All
Thank
right.
you so much for talking.
You got it.
He knows that you're not supposed to mess with me because he knows about the clipper.
I
think we should go talk to him. Okay. I feel as though I know you.
You do know me.
Remind me.
John Rickey, Antelope Island.
Thank you. Okay, John Rickey, I think we need to talk to you a little bit because Farrell was just mouthing off.
Oh, boy.
So I just would like to have you remind him about what I've got and, you know, the kind of friends I have, right?
Well, Clay kind of anointed her with a little tool for changing masculinity, let's say.
Just scoot a little closer, though, like you like one another.
Alrighty, can I get your guys' names?
I'm Andrew.
Trevor.
Cheyenne.
Abby.
And you guys got tickets, or are you just hanging out hoping you can get some free ones?
We got a buddy that's a bull rider, so.
Alright, well, are you guys from Salt Lake?
Yeah.
And who's riding bulls that you know?
His name's Jeremy. He's not for tonight, though.
Oh, he's not riding tonight?
No, he's riding Thursday and Saturday.
I think it's from all of the allergies. Still a little right there.
Can you get it for me? Come on.
You could use your t-shirt.
Holly. Look down.
You gotta...
No, look. You like that?
No, look, I'm trying to help you.
Wait.
No.
Oh, give me that microphone. She claims.
On camera with the flag.
I don't care. She claims that I'm hideous and ew, but you saw it right here. She tried to take my shirt off.
No.
You saw it. No.
Farrell, hey, I'm trying to have a classy, top-notch.
Well, then why?
TV show
then why you take it?
Soon to be syndicated. How will that ever happen if my co-host has a big old bug?
How's it ever going to happen? You're trying to pull off my shirt.
That is true. That was my bad. Don't put that part.
But it looked good, didn't it?
Let's use your sleeve. Or maybe this area. I don't know. We just got to find you a tissue.
I saw you on another show not too long ago when you were threatening somebody else with the tool.
Which one was it? I have a lot of people who need to be threatened.
I don't remember which show.
I work with some hooligans. That's why Clay gave that to me. I mean, he just knew.
I'm a sweetheart. I really am.
Seriously?
I'm just saying.
I don't know how you do it. Okay, so what are you guys doing here tonight? Ribs and fun?
Music. Western music. We follow it all around.
So you just come down here early to get a sneak preview? You're like scoping out his competition and letting him know if he has anything to worry about?
Yeah, pretty much.
And what are you guys doing down here? Just hanging out with these guys or what?
Yeah.
Yeah. What you're trying to say is you got any better sense than to hang out with these two guys?
I don't know. Sure.
Alrighty, guys. Well, thank you for talking with me. I appreciate it.
No problem.
Have a good day.
What are you, my mom?
Sort of. Sort of everyone's. That's the same as producer. Mom. He's getting it. We're lucky here in like Salt Lake and the whole Days of 47. They're doing up big, Farrell.
This is actually more than I thought it was going to be. This is huge.
It is a huge thing. I'm sort of getting hungry, I think.
Here they've done the music on the plaza like this.
It's pretty fun. I'm excited about it.
And there's, I believe there's some big name entertainment later. Yeah. Brandon Jenkins.
Brandon Jenkins right there.
He's going to play right here.
That's his brother. That's
he
his
doesn't
brother
even
Brandon.
Know.
Yeah, that's his brother Brandon.
A lot of people. Tomorrow night is Wiley in the Wild West. He's phenomenal. He travels worldwide, and he'll be here tomorrow night.
All right, should we come back, Farrell?
Maybe we should come back. If you're buying, once again, I ain't done
that. He's so annoying.
Tuesday through Friday.
Are you guys going to be here?
We'll be here every night.
All right. Maybe we'll see you. If not, absolute pleasure. Thank you for reminding me about the tool. Good to see you.
All right, folks. Hey, that's going to do it for me. Hey, Holly, we saw kinds of fun things.
We did. The Clydesdales were my favorite. Yeah, I want one.
Once again, what are you going to do with a Clydesdale?
I don't know.
You know what it would do to your house? Could you imagine that big old Clydesdale?
Because I would totally want it to sleep with me. Like Quincy. Quincy Jones and, you know, the Clydesdale.
That may anger your cat.
No, I bet they'd like each other. That guy was chill. It's true. Okay, so Days of 47, really fun. Thank you, everyone who talked to us. And you know what? If you're at the parade, you should come talk to us there, too, because we're going to be there.
Yeah, it'll be fun.
Pick it up.
I'm always ready to go, Holly. I'm like a... But you know what? I'm going to ride the pony, so...
What was that? Like a cat?
I'll show you what that is. It's like a karate thing.
A karate cat. I'm gonna ride the pony. Terrifying. Wow. Oh.